Welcome to Gayatri's Cook Spot. I am Gayatri Kumar and today I'll show you how to make this beautiful English muffin bread made in a cuboid tin. So if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, like and comment and share. So this bread is very easy to make and it makes amazingly soft and look at the texture, it will be very good. We need a 5 inches by 5 inches by 5 inches loaf tin with a lid. I'll just add the description box the link to buy the tin. Now let's make the dough. 2 maida, 430 grams of maida, add 1 tablespoon of instant yeast. This one can be actually added directly to your flour, but if you're using dry yeast, you need to prove the yeast with a little bit of water from the recipe and then add it to the flour mixture. And you also, you know what, you need to add the same amount of dry yeast as instant yeast. Now add sugar, salt and a little bit of baking soda and mix everything together. So in this bread, we are going to do it only once, like the proving is done only once and it's directly done in the bread tin. We don't actually prove the dough first and then shape it and then put it in the bread tin, but we directly shape it and then put it in the bread tin. So you know, comparatively it takes a lesser amount of time. Now take 250 milliliters of milk and 2 tablespoons of oil. It can be refined oil, it can be coconut oil, or you can also use melted butter for this. Now we're going to heat this mixture. You know, it should be slightly hot than warm. When you dip your finger, you should feel the heat. Just take it out at that time from the flame and then add it to your dry mixture. And now mix everything together. So depending upon the flour you're using, the liquid quantity might be enough or you might need more liquid. So I made this bread 2 times. The first time I used a different kind of maida. It was actually, you know what, perfect to make cakes. So the protein content was less. So what happened is the 250 ml milk I added was actually too much for it. I had a pretty loose dough, but the second time I used a little bit, you know, for paratha maida, which has a bit of more protein, and the 250 ml milk was not actually enough and it made a dry dough. So I'm just showing you the second time I made it. So as you can see, the dough is pretty dry to touch also, and it's you know, it looks kind of dry even by looking at it. You can just see it. So don't worry if it happens with your dough. You can actually add more water or milk or any kind of liquid to bring the dough together. So I'm just going to add some water to bring the dough to correct consistency. So it actually depends upon the maida you're using. So you know, you can either you end up with a loose dough or you end up with a dry dough. So adjust water or milk accordingly. Just you know, wet your palms and just knead your dough. I actually added the whole that bowl of water totally to make my dough softer, and knead the dough for 10 minutes. So this is to activate gluten. You can also check the, you know, window pane test also, whether to, you know, to see whether your dough is ready or not. I'll just link up my window pane test video here in the video itself. You can just take a look at it. Now grease the bread loaf tin with butter and add a parchment paper at the bottom, and also grease your you know, the lid also. Now let us shape your dough. As this is you know, square in shape, actually need a whole, you know, a ball of dough, that's all. You don't have to shape it into log or anything. So just make the top as smooth as possible and just place it inside your tin. So I made the first bread. I made it with 400 grams of flour, and I didn't get that perfect shape on the top. So I next time I just added 30 grams of flour to the recipe, and with 430 grams of flour, it was perfect for the tin. And it also depends upon the recipe you're using. So for this recipe, 430 grams of flour is enough for the tin. Now cover it with cling film and let it double in volume. Now make sure it doesn't come above the rim, okay, because you need to close it with the lid also. So maybe 3/4 or a little bit above that is fine. Just close it with the lid and then let it proof for another 15 minutes, and by that time you also preheat your oven and then bake the loaf for 30 to 40 minutes in the oven. And now you can remove the lid. See, it's perfectly a cube. The top is nice and flat and it has browned equally on all sides. Just remove it out of the tin immediately, because you don't want condensation to form at the bottom of the bread. Now you just allow it to cool completely before slicing. So it may take 2 to 3 hours to cool completely. Before that, don't slice it, because you'll squish the insides of the bread and the texture won't look good. Now use a long serrated knife, bread knife, to slice your bread so that you get neat slices. Sharp knives won't work that good, so just use serrated knife. And let's see how the bread slices. See, the texture is amazing and it's really soft. You know, even though it's proved only once, the texture of the dough, bread is very soft and it's really tasty. So if you are trying, please try it, and then you can also bake this in a normal 4 inches by 4 inches by 8 inches tin also. The same amount of flour you can use for that, or you can use a 7.5 inches loaf tin. So anyhow, you can any type of tin you can use to bake this bread, or you can also bake it as rolls or sandwich bread or hot dog rolls. Anyhow you can bake this to get any kind of bread you want. Just the recipe is very versatile. Just I'll show you how soft it is. See, this is good, right? So please try this and share your results with me in comments here. And if you have any doubts, please ask here in the comments. I'll be very happy to help you. And now I'll show you how I store my bread slices. I just wrap every single bread slice in cling film, and then I'll just store it in an airtight box. If I'm having it in 1 or 2 days, I'll keep it outside, or I just refrigerate it for future use. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.